Let us start the class. Here in unit 2 we have completed representation of sinusoidal waveforms. For sinusoidal waveform we have determined instantaneous value, RMS value and average value. That means for half wave rectifier and full wave rectifier. In exam they will ask for 5 marks. Derive the average and RMS value for half wave rectifier or full wave rectifier. We have completed this RMS value, peak value, phasor representation we have completed. And we also completed real power, reactive power, apparent power, power factor, and single phase circuits for R load, R, L, and C. AC through pure R, AC through pure inductance, AC through pure capacitance. Series RL circuit we have completed. Series RC circuit also we have completed. Series RLC also completed. And parallel circuits also we have done the problems on parallel AC circuits. And today we'll start the resonance. Today we'll start resonance topic. Okay. So resonance in series RLC circuit. So only you are having resonance in series. There is no parallel. Resonance in parallel is not there in your syllabus. I might have given the question in the assignment, but don't take that one. Only resonance in series RLC circuit is in your syllabus. I will explain this series RLC resonance today. And last topic in the second unit is three-phase balanced circuits. Three-phase balanced circuits, voltage and current relations in three-phase star and delta. Last topic is three-phase connections. So today we'll start the resonance in series RLC circuit. If you complete resonance, only one topic is left out, that is three-phase balanced circuits. So let us start the resonance. I'm writing on the board, 1 minute. I'll write it on the board.
Listen here. Madam's reading. Resonance in series RLC circuit. Resonance in series RLC circuit. Resonance in series RLC circuit. Draw the series RLC R, L and C. RLC. Right up. Resonance in series RLC circuit. Draw this circuit. Okay, listen here. Write down the resonance condition. Siding resonance condition. Resonance condition. XL is equal to XC. Resonance condition is XL is equal to XC. XL is equal to XC. Now I am removing this. Resonance condition is XL is equal to XC. XL is equal to XC. What is XL formula? What is the formula for XL?
Omega L.
Omega L. Formula for XL is
one by omega C.
1 by omega. Now at resonance, I am taking it as omega naught. At resonance, I am taking it as omega naught. Instead of omega, I am taking it as omega naught at resonance. This is the resonance condition. XL is equal to XC. That is, omega naught square is equal to, bring omega to this side, 1 by LC. Omega naught is equal to 1 by root LC. This is the formula for omega naught under resonance condition. Under resonance condition, this is the formula for omega naught. Right on. Now I am writing omega naught is equal to 2 pi f naught. Omega naught is equal to 2 pi f naught. And the resonant frequency f naught is equal to 1 by 2 pi root LC. This is the formula for resonant frequency. You have to remember this formula. This is the formula for resonant frequency. This is under resonance condition, formula for resonant frequency is f naught is equal to 1 by 2 pi root LC. F naught is equal to 1 by 2 pi root LC. This is the formula for resonant frequency. Remember this formula omega naught, and remember this formula also. For omega naught, there is no 1 by 2 pi. For F naught, 1 by 2 pi is there. Remaining formula is same. 1 by 2 pi root LC. This is the formula for resonant frequency. This derivation is important. They'll ask for 2 marks. This derivation for F naught, they'll ask for 2 marks. Now see here. Now from RLC circuit, what is the Z formula? Z is equal to R plus. What is the formula for Z? Z is equal to R plus J into. This is the formula for Z. This is the formula for Z. Z is in RLC circuit. For R, it is R. For L, it is XL plus JXL minus JXC. Z is equal to R plus J into XL minus XC. Now, under resonance condition, what is the resonance condition? What is the resonance condition?
XL is equal to
X. XL is equal to XC. What is this value now?
Zero.
Right on. Under resonance, Z is equal to R. Under resonance, your impedance is equal to resistance. This formula is important. Under resonance, your impedance is equal to resistance because XL minus XC is 0. Write on this. You should remember this. Under resonance, resonance means XL is equal to XC and Z is equal to R. Z is equal to R. Okay. Now I'll draw the graph for this resonance. Now I'll draw the graphs for resonance. See here how I'll draw the graph for resonance. An x-axis, I'm taking the frequency. On y-axis, I will take Z. On y-axis, I will take Z, R, XL, XC, XL minus XC, and I. So the on y-axis, I will take all these parameters. What are the parameters? Z, R, XL, XC, XL minus XC. I'll take all the parameters on y-axis. On y-axis, I'm taking all these parameters. We'll take one by one. See here, first I'm taking this is 0. First I'm taking XL. First, I will take Excel. What is the formula for Excel? Omega.
Omega.
Okay. Excel is omega. Omega is 2 pi f. Omega is 2 pi f. First, I am taking Excel graph. Now, Excel is, our X axis, I am taking frequency. How Excel is related to frequency? Directly proportional or inversely proportional?
Directly.
Directly.
Excel is directly proportional to frequency. Now, first I am taking Excel on Y axis. Now, F is equal to 0. Excel is on, if F is 0, Excel is 0. If F is 1, Excel is 1. See here, I am taking 1, 2, 3 like this. Here also 1, 2, 3 on Y axis. If both are 1 here, if both are 2 here, that means how the graph is varying? Linearly. Your Excel graph is varying linearly. Okay? Because it is directly proportional to F. Excel is directly proportional to F. Write down here. Excel is directly proportional to F. If F is 0, Excel is 0. Suppose if F is infinity, if F is infinity, what is Excel?
Then Excel will also be infinity.
If Excel is also infinity. So here, like this. And if it will go to, if F is infinity, your Excel will also go to infinity. This is the graph for Excel. This is the graph for Excel. If F is equal to F0, let us take F0 here, resonant frequency. If F is equal to F0, Excel is also some value here. Okay? At X is equal to, F is equal to infinity, Excel is infinity. It will go to infinity. Okay? That is the first graph for Excel. Because directly proportional, it is linearly increasing. If F is increasing, Excel is also increasing. This is the graph for Excel. Now I will take the graph for XC. Next, I will take the graph for XC. XC is equal to, what is the formula?
1 by omega c.
1 by omega c. If it is 1 by omega c, that is 1 by 2 pi fc. Now, XC is inversely proportional to 1 by f. XC is inversely proportional to 1 by f. Now, see here. I am not having space. You write it in your notebook. You know, Z is equal to R plus J XL minus XC. What is XC, positive or negative? XC is positive or negative? It is negative. Take here minus. XC is inversely proportional to minus 1 by F. XC is inversely proportional to here in Z, we are having minus here. So XC is inversely proportional to minus 1 by F. Take down this, write down in your notes. XC is inversely proportional to minus 1 by F. XC is inversely proportional to minus 1 by F. Now substitute F is equal to 0. Substitute F is equal to 0. What is XC? What is XC?
Infinity.
Infinity, sir.
1 by 0 is infinity, but minus is there. Minus is there means minus infinity. Now take down F is equal to infinity. Take F is equal to infinity. What is XC? What is 1 by infinity?
0.
So your XC is varying from minus infinity to 0. Your XC curve is varying from minus infinity to 0. Your XL is varying from 0 to infinity, but your XC is varying from minus infinity to 0. See here. Have you written this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now see here. I am drawing the XC curve from minus infinity. If F is 0, it is minus infinity. Somewhere here at the bottom. Minus infinity. Now take F is equal to infinity. If F is infinity, what is the XC value? If F is infinity, what is XC value?
Zero.
Zero.
It is coming to zero. This is the graph for xc. It is varying from, for f is 0, it is minus infinity. Somewhere it is minus infinity. From minus infinity, it is starting, it is going to 0 at when f is infinity. When f is infinity, it is going to 0. This is the graph. Xc is varying from minus infinity to 0. Now I will take the graph for XL minus XC. Now I will take the graph for XL minus XC. XL minus XC. Now see here. X is it not visible? XL is directly proportional to F. XC is inversely proportional to 1 by F. XL is directly proportional to F. XC is inversely proportional to 1 by F. XC is inversely proportional to 1 by F. Now take F is equal to 0. Then what is XL minus XC? Substitute here 0. F is 0. 0 minus 1 by 0. What is 1 by 0?
0.
0 minus infinity. Then what is the value of XL minus XC?
Minus
infinity. This is the first case. Now take the second case. F is equal to, write down this also. First case. In first case, write down this. 0 minus 1 by 0. That is 0 minus infinity. We will get minus infinity. Now I am taking F is equal to F naught. Now I am taking F is equal to F naught. At F naught, what is the condition? At F naught, what is the condition?
XL is equal to
XC. XL is equal to XC. If XL is equal to XC, what is the value of XL minus XC?
0.
If XL is equal to XC, what is this value?
0.
0, sir.
Write down 0. XL minus XC. Infinity minus 1 by infinity. That is infinity minus 0. 1 by infinity is 0. What is the value of XL minus XC? What is the value?
Infinity.
If F is infinity, 1 by infinity is 0. Infinity minus 0 is infinity. Then XL minus XC value is infinity. I have written these three conditions, first condition, second and third.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now see here how to draw the graph for XL minus XC. Now first I am taking the first condition. F is equal to 0. See here. If F is equal to 0, what is the value of XL minus XC?
Minus infinity.
Minus infinity. Minus infinity means here, at negative side, downward, negative y-axis. Minus F. At F is equal to F, F naught, what is the value?
Zero,
sir. Now see here, minus infinity to 0 I am drawing. Minus infinity to 0 at F naught. At F naught, minus infinity to 0. Now at f is equal to infinity, what is the value?
Infinity.
Infinity.
Here, I am drawing infinity. This is the graph for XL minus XC. It is varying from minus infinity to 0 and it is going to infinity. Somewhere these two lines will touch. At infinity. At infinity, these two lines will touch. At f is 0, XL is 0. At f is equal to infinity, XL is also infinity. XL is also infinity. Now XL minus XC is also infinity. It is going to infinity. When F is infinity, XL minus XC is going to infinity. Any doubt in these three curves? XL, XC and XL minus XC? Okay. Next I am going to Z. Z is equal to hypotenuse square is equal to side square plus side square. We know Z is equal to R plus J, XL minus XC. If you take hypotenuse square, if you draw the right angle triangle for Z is equal to R plus J, XL minus XC, hypotenuse square is equal to R is one side, XL minus XC is another side. Hypotenuse square is equal to side square plus side square. Bring this square to this side. It will become square root. If you bring the square to this side, it becomes square root. Now see here. Now I am taking here R is independent of frequency. R is independent of frequency. Listen here. First, I will draw the graph. Before Z, I will draw the graph for R. R is independent of frequency. R is not directly proportional to frequency, inversely proportional. It is not related to frequency at all. Suppose if R is equal to 10 ohms. Let us take R is equal to 10 ohms. See here. R is constant. This is the graph for R. 10 ohms. It is independent of frequency. If R is 0, this is the line. If R is equal to 20 ohms, this is the line. R is constant. It is not depending on the frequency. R is not depending on frequency. This is the curve for resistance. See here, this is the curve for resistance. It is constant. At any point of F, the value is constant. If R is 20 ohms, this will be 20, line will be 20 ohms. Okay. Now I will draw the graph for Z. See, XL is directly proportional to F. XC is inversely proportional to 1 by F. XC is inversely proportional to 1 by F. And R is independent of frequency. R is independent of frequency. First, let us take the first condition. F is equal to 0. If F is equal to 0, now substitute F is equal to 0. Z is equal to square root of R square plus 0 minus 1 by 0. What is 0 minus 1 by 0?
Minus infinity.
Square root of R square plus minus infinity square. Minus infinity square is?
Infinity square.
Plus infinity. Is it infinity? Infinity plus R is infinity only. Infinity plus R is infinity only. Write down this. 0 minus 1 by 0. Whole square. 0 minus 1 by 0. Whole square. Square is there here. 0 minus. At F is equal to 0, your Z is infinity. Write down this first condition. In rough, you can write this. Now I am removing this. Now substitute F is equal to F naught. At F is equal to F naught, what is the value of XL and XC?
0. XL minus XC is equal to 0.
XL minus XC is 0. That means this, there is no, this term is not there. Then what is the value of Z?
R.
R. So R square. R square means square root and R will be cancelled. Z is equal to R. At F is equal to F naught, your Z is equal to R. At F is equal to F naught, your Z is R. Now take F is equal to infinity. Now substitute here. Third condition. F is equal to infinity. F is infinity minus 1 by infinity whole square. That is infinity minus 0 whole square. What is the value of Z?
Infinity.
Z is equal to infinity. Your Z is equal to infinity. See here, R plus infinity is infinity only. So by using this condition, I'll draw the graph now. by using these three conditions: f zero, f is equal to f naught, and f is equal to infinity. I draw the graph for z. So what is this line? What is this line?
R.
R. Resistance is constant. Now see here, f is equal to zero, z is infinity. When f is zero, this is zero. F is zero on x-axis. Your z is infinity on y-axis. Somewhere I will take here infinity point. It will go beyond this. Beyond this, it will go. Infinity means somewhere it is on the and when f is zero. From infinity, when f is equal to f naught, what is the value of z?
R.
R. See here, f naught is here. R is here. At f naught, your z value is r. From minus, sorry, from infinity to r. I am drawing the curve from infinity. When f is zero, it is infinity. From infinity to z is equal to r. This curve is touching the r. At f naught, it is touching the curve r. Okay. Now again, when f is equal to infinity or z is infinity, it will go to infinity. It will go to infinity. When f is equal to infinity, when f is equal to infinity, it will go again to infinity somewhere. It will again go to infinity. Okay. Is there any doubt in the graph of z? This is z. This is the graph for z. It is touching the r. When f is equal to f naught, again it will go to infinity. When f is equal to infinity, this is the curve for z. Next, I will draw the curve for current. I will draw the curve for current now. What is the formula for current? What is the formula for current?
Yeah.
In RLC circuit?
V by Z.
V by Z. Your I is equal to V by Z. Now see here, at F is equal to 0, what is Z? What is Z?
Infinity.
Infinity. That is V by infinity. What is V by infinity?
Zero.
Zero. Your current is zero. Write down here. At f is equal to zero, your current is, write down this also. I is equal to V by Z. First take f is equal to zero. Sorry. Sorry, infinity. Z is infinity, no? Z is infinity. 1 by infinity is zero. Okay. Your current is zero. Write down this. When f is equal to zero, Z is infinity. Z value is substitute infinity. Z value, I am substituting infinity. Your current is zero. When f is zero, your current infinity. Z is infinity, but current is zero. Now come to the second case. What is the value? What is the value of I?
V by R.
V by R. Write down. I is equal to V by R. When f is equal to infinity, your I is equal to V by R. Write down here. I is equal to V by R. When F is equal to F naught, your current is V by R. Now take the last case. F is equal to infinity, Z is also infinity. What is the value of current?
Zero.
Zero.
Zero. Your current is zero. When F is equal to infinity, your current is zero. Now I'll draw the curve for current. Now tell me, at f is equal to zero, what is your current?
Zero.
Zero. This is zero here. Current, when f is zero, current is also zero. Your current is also zero here. At f is equal to f naught, I is equal to V by R. One thing you tell me, when z is infinity, z infinity means maximum or minimum z value?
Maximum. Infinity means
maximum.
Maximum. Then what is current?
Zero.
Minimum. Okay, minimum. Current is minimum. Because current is inversely proportional to Z. See here, I is inversely proportional to Z. If impedance is maximum, your current will be minimum, zero. If impedance is minimum, see here, Z is equal to R. Impedance is minimum. Your current will be this current. Z is equal to R at F is maximum. Your current will be maximum. At resonant frequency, note on right note point, at resonant frequency, your current will be maximum. Write on the note. At F is equal to F naught, at resonant frequency, impedance is minimum. Write on. At resonant frequency, impedance is minimum. Current will be maximum. At resonant frequency, impedance is minimum. Current will be maximum. This point is very important. In the problem also, you use this point. At resonant frequency, impedance is minimum because XL is equal to XC. And current will be maximum. See here, I am drawing the graph. At F is equal to F naught, take one dot here. At F is equal to F naught, the current is varying from minimum to maximum value. This is the maximum value. This is y-axis. This is the maximum current, I naught. This is the maximum current, I naught. I naught is also called as IM. IM is the maximum current. I naught is the, at F naught we are having maximum current, I naught. At F naught we are having maximum current. Again, when F is equal to infinity, what is the current?
Zero.
Current is?
Zero.
Zero. At F is equal to infinity, this current will come to zero. At F is equal to infinity, this current will come to zero. When F goes to infinity. This is the graph for current. Please remember, at resonant frequency, you'll get maximum current, I naught. At F naught, I am taking it as I naught. IM is the, or I naught. Or IM, sorry. I naught or IM, both are one and same. Maximum current or I naught at F naught. See, the curve for I is inversely proportional to Z. Z curve is decreasing, but current curve is increasing. Exactly opposite to Z, we'll get the current curve. So these are the graphs. First we had drawn XL, then we had drawn XC, then we had drawn XL minus XC, then we had drawn R, then Z, then I. Totally how many curves? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 curves. In this graph we are having 6 curves. If you are having any doubt in these 6 curves, you can ask. Any doubt in these curves? In exam, you have to draw all these curves for 5 marks. This is a compulsory question in the university exam. Explain resonance. We have to derive the formula for F naught. What is the resonant condition?
XC equals to XL.
XL is equal to XC. That is the condition you have, right? And you have to derive the formula for omega naught and F naught. Omega naught is 1 by root LC. F naught is 1 by 2 pi root LC. After writing the formula for F naught, you have to draw all these 6 curves. If you draw all these 6 curves, they will give 5 marks. In exam, only these 6 curves you draw. Don't write F is equal to 0, F is equal to F naught, F is equal to F infinity, all those. These are not necessary. Only the curves are necessary. Why I have explained means for your understanding purpose, I have taken F is equal to 0, F is equal to F naught, F is equal to infinity. In exam, there is no need to write all the explanation. Only curves you have to draw. Okay? Now see here. Resonance in RLC circuits. These are the six columns which we had. Excel, this is Excel, this is XC, this is Excel minus XC. X is equal to Excel minus XC. And this is the curve for Z. This is the curve for Z. This is the curve for current. At resonant frequency F naught, at resonant frequency F naught, we are having maximum current. Impedance is minimum. Current will be maximum. Impedance is minimum. Your current will be maximum. Okay. On x-axis they are taking frequency. On y-axis they are taking all the parameters. Next we will go for right-hand side, determination of upper and lower half-power frequencies. Right-hand side, determination of upper and lower half-power frequencies. Determination of upper and lower half-power frequencies. Upper and lower half-power frequencies. Side. Okay, listen here. Observe the current curve. Now I will take the current curve and I will explain the half power frequencies. Current is increasing from 0 to infinite, maximum to 0. Okay, listen here. And take the current 0. This is F naught. Resonant frequency. So this is the curve for R. This is R curve. Resistance curve. Resistance is independent of frequency. Now at F is equal to 0, your current is 0. At F is equal to F naught, your current is maximum. Again, current will decrease to 0. This is the graph for the current. Your maximum current, what I had told at F naught?
I naught.
Okay. I naught or IM, maximum current. Now, while calculating the power, we'll take RMS values. We won't take the maximum values. Already I had told, while calculating the power, we'll take only RMS values. That means, we know the formula for RMS current. What is the formula for RMS current? What is the formula? In full wave rectifier, what is the formula for RMS
current?
Not audible.
Peak value by root 2, maximum.
Maximum value by root 2. Here I am taking IM is I naught. Maximum value is I naught. I naught by root 2. That is 0.707 I naught. This is 1 into I naught. I naught by root 2 means here 0.707. Here it is I naught by root 2. Your RMS current is I. Let us take I is the RMS current. I is equal to I naught by root 2. I naught by root 2 means here, this value. From this, take one straight line. From I naught by root 2, 0.707, take one straight line. 0.707 of I naught. This is 1 into I naught. I'm taking one line here. Now, this line is cutting the graph here and also here. This line is cutting the graph at this point and also at this point. Now, take one line. Here also take one line. This is called upper cutoff frequency. This is called lower cutoff frequency. I am taking this point as lower cutoff frequency. this point as upper cutoff frequency. This is upper cutoff frequency. This will be lower cutoff frequency. Draw this curve. Draw this graph.
F1 is lower.
Any doubt?
F1 is lower, sir.
F1 is called lower cutoff frequency. F2 is called upper cutoff frequency. F0 is resonant frequency. F0 is resonant frequency. F2 is upper value. See, F is equal to F2 is higher value when compared to F1. F1 is called lower cutoff frequency. Now let us assume that power at F1 is P1, power at F1 is P1, power at F2 is P2, power at F0 is P0, power at F1 is P1, power at F2 is P2, power at F0 is P0. Now I will determine the power at F0. What is the power at F0, P0? Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Current is I0 at P0. I0 square into R. Now I will determine P1 is equal to P2. P1 is equal to P2. What is the current at F1? What is the current at F1?
RMS value.
I not by root. I not by root 2 whole square into R. Here, RMS current. RMS current is I. I square. This is I square. I is equal to I not by root 2. I is equal to I not by root 2. Now, can you tell me this value I naught square into R? Root 2 whole square is? Root 2 whole square is 2. This is root 2 whole square is 2. Now, what is the value of P1 and P2 in terms of P0? Your P1 is equal to P2 is equal to?
Half of P1.
Resonant power. P1 is equal to P2 is equal to P0 by 2. That is half of, this is the conclusion. Half of the resonant power. Half of the resonant power. I0 square is P0. P0 by 2. That is half of the resonant power. Your P1 is equal to P2 is equal to P0 by 2. That means since power is half, this F1 and F2 are called half power frequencies. F1 and F2 are called half power frequencies. F1 and F2 are called half power frequency. F1 and F2 are called half power frequencies. Is it clear why they are calling it as half power frequencies?
Yes, sir.
Because the power is half when compared to resonant frequency. At resonant frequency, power is P0. But at the half power frequencies, your power is reduced by half. That's why F1 and F2 are called half power frequencies. In exam, they were asked to derive the formula for half power frequencies. You had to derive P1 is equal to P2 is equal to F0 by P0 by 2. And you had to draw this curve. We had to draw this curve. Okay, next side heading. Quality factor. In resonance, one parameter is there, very important. They'll ask for 2 marks. Sometimes they'll ask the problem for 5 marks in quality factor. Right on side heading. quality factor is represented with Q. Quality factor is represented with Q. Q is equal to voltage across inductance by voltage across resistance, or Q is equal to VC by VR. The quality factor is defined as voltage across inductance by voltage across resistance, or voltage across capacitance by voltage across resistance. Quality factor. Denominator is same, but in numerator, inductance and capacitance is there. Numerator, inductance and capacitance will be there. Voltage across inductance, voltage across capacitance. What is the formula for VR? VL? I into XL. What is the formula for VR?
I by VR.
I into R. Current multiplied by reactance. Unit of XL is ohms. Unit of R is also ohms. VC is I into XC. VR is I into R. Now this I will be cancelled. This I and I cancels. This I and I also cancel. Then I will get XL by R. Here XC by R. This is XL by R. This is XC by R. Now here I am writing XL. What is the formula for XL? What is the formula for XL? Omega L. What is the formula for XC?
1 by omega C.
Okay, 1 by omega C. These are the formulas for quality factor. Q is equal to omega L by R. Q is equal to 1 by omega R C. Suppose in the problem, if they give R and L and frequency, omega is 2 pi f. Frequency also, if they give R and L and frequency, this formula you had to use. If in the problem he is giving R, C and F, you had to use this formula. If you know only R and L, we'll use this. If you know R and C, we'll use this formula for quality factor. There is no unit for the quality factor because ohms by ohms, there is no unit. Here also ohm by ohm, there is no unit for the quality factor. These are the two formulas. Now I'll tell one more formula. Suppose if you know F, L and R, we are determining. If I don't know F, I know only R, L and C. One more formula is there. See here. What is the formula for omega we have derived in the starting? What is the formula for omega?
2 pi f.
Omega is 1 by root LC. Omega is 1 by root LC. L by R. Now simplify this. Simplify this. L and root L. What do you get? Are you getting this? If you simplify this. Okay. Now see here. 1 by R root of L by C. This is 1 by omega RC. Omega value is 1 by root LC. This is RC. Now substitute omega is 1 by root LC. Omega is 1 by root LC. Bring this root LC to the numerator. Bring this root LC to the numerator. Root LC by RC. Simplify this, we'll get 1 by R square root of L by C. If you simplify this, we'll get this. C and root L. Here under root square, root C will get 1 by R root of L by C. Here also you get 1 by R root of L by C. This is the third formula. First formula. First, write on this. So now I am writing the formulas for quality factor. XL by R, first formula. R, XC by R. Next. omega n by r, r 1 by omega rc. These are the two formulas. Next formula for q is 1 by r root of l by c. In exam, we can take any formula. If you know l and r, we can take this formula. If you know r and c, we'll take this formula. If you don't know the frequency, then you can take this formula. If you know r, l and c. These are the three formulas. This is first formula. This is the second formula. This is the third formula. Totally three formulas are there. XL is omega L. XC is 1 by omega C. XC is 1 by omega C. Okay. These are the three formulas. Now I will define one more formula for quality factor. Last formula for the quality factor. Quality factor is equal to, right on, resonant frequency by equal to resonant frequency by bandwidth. Resonant frequency by bandwidth. This is F2 and this is F1. Resonant frequency is F0. What is the bandwidth now? Bandwidth is equal to upper cutoff frequency minus lower cutoff frequency. Bandwidth is equal to F2 minus F1. So from here to here, this is the bandwidth. F2 minus F1. Bandwidth is F2 minus F1. This is the formula for resonant frequency. Sorry, quality factor. Quality factor is equal to resonant frequency by bandwidth. In exam, sometimes they'll give F0, F1, and F2. Okay, they'll ask to determine the quality factor. This is one another formula for quality factor. Now see here. Multiply both numerator and denominator with 2 pi. Sometimes they'll give omega naught, omega 1 and omega 2. This is also formula for quality factor. 2 pi f naught is omega naught. 2 pi f2 is omega 2. 2 pi f1 is omega 1. This is one more formula for quality factor. Okay, that's all about the resonance. Problems on resonance we'll see in tomorrow's class. Problems on resonance we'll see in afternoon. There is class, I think.
Yes, sir.
In afternoon class, yes, we'll see the problems on quality factor. And also, we'll discuss some questions in unit 1 and unit 2. Some important questions in unit 1 and unit 2 for mid exam. Okay. Now I am ending the class here. I'll take the attendance. Wait for some time. So these are the absent days. 5, 35, 36, 41, 46, 52. Now you can exit.